I'm going to go over some slick ways to tell if a number is divisible by 11 or if it's divisible by 13. In a previous video, I went over the divisibility test for 11, but it was only for 3-digit numbers, and so I'm going to go over how to do it for larger numbers. And there are two different tests for 11, so you could learn both of them and decide which one's easiest for you. All right, so let's start off with a 3-digit number. What I said was if you had a 3-digit number like 374, what you do is you add the outside numbers and subtract the middle number. So if you add 3 and 4, you get 7, minus 7, and you get 0. And it was divisible by 11 as long as the answer was 0 or 11. Then it was divisible by 11. So I'm going to say yes, this is divisible by 11. Let's do one more. Let's say I have 869 and I want to know if this is divisible by 11. So I add the outside digits. 8 plus 9 is 17, minus 6, and I got 11. So you know what? This is also, I got an 11 again. So this is also yes, divisible by 11. Let's do one more where maybe it's not divisible by 11. How about 837? Okay, so if I add the outside two digits, 8 plus 7, I get 15 minus 3, which is 12, and I didn't get a 0 or 11. So this is a test if you've got a 3-digit number. Now, let's go a little bit further. What if I don't have a 3-digit number? So let's say I have this number 108064, and I want to know if this is divisible by 11. Well, what you do is, starting with the first digit, you add it to every other digit. So in other words, I'm going to add the 1, the 8, and the 6, and that adds up to what? 1 plus 8 is 9, plus 6 is 15. And then I'm going to add the other digits and the other place values. These three numbers, 0, 0, and 4, add up to 4. Now what you do is you subtract the two numbers. And if you get any number that 11 goes into, like 0, 11, or 22, if it's some huge number of numbers, digits, then the answer is yes. So yes, 108064 is divisible by 11. All right, now this doesn't tell you what it equals when you divide by 11, but you can get out a calculator and check that out pretty easily, or do long division. But what it's telling you is if you do now do that long division or use a calculator, it will not have a remainder. So for this problem, when you divide by 11, you get 98.24. All right, let's use this method on one more number at least. How about 78231? Let's say you want to know if this number is divisible by 11. So you start with the first digit, add every other digit. So that gives me 7, 2, and 1 is 10. And then the other numbers down here get added together and I get 11. And you just subtract. 11 minus 10 is 1. So this is not divisible by 11. 7, 8, 2, 3, 1 is not divisible by 11. So if you try putting that in a calculator, you'll see you're going to get a remainder. Divisible, let's write that right. So that's one way of finding out that this number is divisible by 11. Now I'm going to show you another method for the same numbers. All right, so we determined that this number, 108,064, is divisible by 11. Now I'm going to show you another way of doing this. You start with a number, 108,064. You cross off the last number and subtract it from what's left. So I'm just going to subtract it from 108,006. So that's 108,002. I just do it again. So I'm going to take off the last number, subtract it from what's left, and that's going to give me 1078. Take the last number, subtract it from what's left, and I get 99. And when I finally get down to a two-digit number, you should know whether 11 goes into it. And 11 goes into 99. So since it goes into 99, it's divisible by, it's also 108,064 is also divisible by 11. So you just take the last digit, get rid of it, subtract it from the rest of the numbers if that number is now gone. Let's do it on the other one we figured out. All right, we found out that this number was not divisible by 11. Let's use the same test here. So I start out with the original number, 78231. You cross off the last digit and subtract it from what's left, which is 7822. Just keep doing it until you get to a two-digit number that you know. So you take off the last digit, subtract it from what's left, and I get 780. Take the last digit, subtract it from what's left, so you're just subtracting 0, and 78. And does 11 go into 78? No. So that's why 78,231 is not divisible by 11. Let's do one more problem. How about if I'm just going to pick some random number like, 314926? I want to know if this number is divisible by 11 using this second method. You try it and then come back. Put the video on pause and then try it. Let's do it. Okay, take off the last number, subtract 6, and that gives me 31486. Take off the last digit, which is 6 again, and subtract 6. That gives me 3142. Take off the last digit, subtract it from what's left. I have 312. Take the last digit, which is 2, and subtract it, and I get 29. Does 11 go into 29? No. So this number, it's not divisible by 11. So, let's just do that one using the first method I showed you. Remember what that was? 314926. You do every other digit, add those, so that's 9. And then at the bottom, we add every other digit, which is 16. And 16 minus 9 is 7. So, 11 does not go into 7. So, also not divisible by 11. All right, going on to the divisibility test for 13. Without actually having to do the division. You take the number 7566, and again you cross off that last digit, but you know what you do this time? You multiply it by 4 and add it to the leftover number. So I have to do, the last digit was 6, so 6 times 4 is 24. That's what I add to the rest of the number. So that gives me 780. And then I just do this again. I take the last digit, which happens to be 0, so 0 times 4 is just 0, and I add that, and I have 78. Now, 78 is a multiple of 13, it's divisible, but let's say you didn't know this. You could just do this again. You could take the last digit off, which is 8, and 8 times 4 is 32, and you get 39. And 13 does go into 39. So what you must know for the divisibility test is you have to know these numbers. You have to know that 13 times 1, 13 times 2, and 13 times 3. If you do this, you'll eventually either get, if it is divisible by 13, you'll get 13, 26, or 39. Otherwise, it's not divisible by 13. So this number, 7566, is divisible by 13. You can now get out a calculator, do long division, and you'll find out that the answer is 582. Okay, so if you did 7566 divided by 13, you would get 582. Now you would know it goes in evenly. All right, let's do another number. Is 7,405 divisible by 13? All right, so we're going to start the same method. We cross off the last digit, multiply it by 4. Remember to do the 5 times 4 and add it. So that gives me 760. And we do it again. Pull, the last digit is 0. That's easy. 0 times 4 is just 0. So we're going to add 0. And is 76 divisible by 13? No. But let's say you just weren't sure. Just do it one more step. You go down until you're sure. So you have to now do the 6 times 4. Right, you're going to cross off the 6 and you're going to add 24, and that's 31. So basically, when you get a number smaller than 40, that's how you know the answer. You have to know that 0, 13, 26, 39, those are the multiples of 13. So the answer to this is no, it's not divisible. All right, so kind of cool methods for dividing by, to tell if a number is divisible by 11 or a number is divisible by 13.